Dulwich Hamlet and Braintree Town lock horns again tonight, with a victor earning their place in the quarterfinals of this year's build-based FA Trophy. Hamlet will be slightly disappointed they didn't see off their National League opponents on Saturday, with a flurry of second-half opportunities ultimately coming and going. Still hopeful of a last eight spot for the first time since 1980, Gavin Rose has been forced into one change from Saturday, with Nyron Clunis ruled out with a knee injury and Ibrissa Kadja replacing him in the lineup. Braintree arrived tonight with another chance to make the quarterfinals for the first time in their history, in this their fifth last 16 appearance. Hakan Hayriton has also rung the changes, as top scorer Michael Cheek misses out through injury, whilst Henschel and Corner dropped. In come Harry Lee, Reese Hall-Johnson and Lee Bernard. The prize for tonight's winners will be a home tie against Macclesfield Town at the end of the month, but who will be celebrating come the end of the evening?
Dulwich finding an early goal here. Carew to deliver. Players congregating edge of the area. Comes a bit more pace than usual from Carew. Might drop for Green. Can't quite find the space to fire in the shot. He's still on the ball. It was blocked by Weatherstone. Chambers sends in the latest cross. Hit by Tomlin and well blocked. Good attack for Dulwich. Neil Johnson will take the corner. There's Mark Weatherstone who clears. And effectively, Lee. Well, Johnson. The overlap here is Twardek. This cross deflects. Harry Lee enters the area. Drills it goalwards. Wide of Preston Edwards' far post. Looked fairly comfortable, the goalkeeper. Chambers floats it up towards the Kadja. Controls in front of Parry. Manages to release Carew. Not been able to get on the ball as much as he'd like so far. Tomlin to Ming. Tomlin again linking up with Carew. They do this so well, those two. Tomlin shrugs off the challenge. On he goes. Just broke down the edge of the area there. Tomlin shrugged off the ball in the end. Twardek on a run past Green. Clohessy's on the overlap and he's been picked out. Good spot by the winger. That's into the side netting. And there's a corner. Pannard shot blocked by Drage. Green. Sakadja in support on this left-hand side. Finds Kuros, a nice pass. Trying to roll off, Tomlin goes down. Turns penalty. Tomlin tried to roll his man. Went down, Goodman can't believe it. And Dulwich have been given a penalty by Craig Hicks. Big moment in this first half and in this cup tie. Up steps Carew. Sends in the wrong way. And Dulwich have a lead here against Braintree Town. Calmly done by Carew. Had chances to win the game on Saturday. Hit the post, forced the keeper into a good save, but make sure he scores tonight. Fourth penalty he scored this season. I'll say Carew stepped up. Besson went to his right. Carew went to his left. And Dulwich, the underdogs, have a lead. Drage, what a ball that is. Carew at the edge of the area. Scuck under his feet a little bit. Tomlin. Just slowing it down. He might go for goal. He does. Deflects. Corner kick for Dulwich. The crowd roaring them on here. So far, Dulwich have dealt with them. Can't keep giving away free kicks in this sort of position. It's been a bit of a Achilles heel for them this season. Another decent ball in. Chambers this time got the touch. Lee hammers that back into the area. Midson well controlled. Strikes it goalwards. It's past the far post. There's a goal kick. Might feel it should have been a corner in the penalty area. Midson and Bernard in particular. And Lee's shot wasn't going to trouble Edwards. Well controlled though by Jack Midson in that penalty area. Just trying to place it across Edwards. I think Kevin James actually asking the question on the touchline. Drage sends that free kick towards the Kadja. Lays it off for Carew on his weaker left foot. And that's why it wasn't hit with as much power as his right would have done. And a comfortable save for Besant, just falling onto the ball. Parry and Goodman again moving forward. Reese Hall-Johnson with his right foot from this near side. And it comes towards the near post, 1-1. It's Jerome Okimo who's got up above his mark and nodded into the top corner, and Braintree weren't behind for long. Just 10 minutes, they were trailing. Wonderful ball in by Hall-Johnson. Okimo got across his marker at the near post. Heads it home. And back to square one, 1-1. Clohessy. Braintree trying to up the ante a little. Twardek. Well done, Chambers. For the moment. Twardek goes on, though. Picks out Hall Johnson. Cross deflects and Edwards holds on. That's a good grab by the goalkeeper because Midson was in the vicinity. Referee doing his final checks. And we go for part two. Will it be the final 45 minutes of this evening? Time will tell. Braintree, if they can continue to dominate, could find a way through this Dulwich defence. Twardek already on the ball here in an advanced position. Hall Johnson wants it in front of him. He's gone for goal early on, parried away by the keeper. And it's going to come for Beanie. Bernard couldn't take it in his stride. I think Edwards may have been a bit unsighted. Came through a defender's leg, but good save by the keeper. That's a deep ball in. And goal kick. Sanchez Ming. Comes inside a little. Finds Tomlin. Ming's continued his run. Got some space, Ming. Low ball in. So catches there, not a million miles from getting a touch. Just beyond his reach in the end. It's come for Twardek, tussling with Green, who's nicked it off him. Green's turn to get forward, that's pumped away by Sean Clohessy. Drage decides to bring it down himself rather than use his keeper. Another way by Clohessy. Twardek, Beanie gets that challenge, trying to get to the second as well. Sakaja, good tenacity from Beanie to keep it alive for his side. Carew. It's gone for goal. It's a long way off target from Carew. Ball was stuck under his feet. I'm not sure that was the right thing to attempt from Dulwich's goal scorer. Okimo with the throw. Bernard. Midson flicks it on. No one in behind. Did that in the first half on Saturday, winning a lot of headers in and around that area, but no one in behind. Tomlin tussles with Goodman. That's going to go back to Besant. Sakaja trying to get in, though. Might deflect for Sakaja. It's going to be a crazy own goal. Dulwich retake the lead in bizarre fashion. Besson has kicked that against Manny Parry and it's flown into his own net. Fluky goal. Dulwich won't mind. That's so unfortunate for Manny Parry. Goodman played his pass back towards Besson. It was a bit under hit, so Besson came charging off his goal line. As Sakaja tried to close him down, his clearance struck the back of Manny Parry. Lee this time with his left foot to curl this in. Just needs a glancing head on this for Lee. And it comes. It's Weatherstone away. Hall Johnson takes a touch. Chips it wide towards Clohessy. Control decent enough to keep it in play. Twardek can take a touch before delivering. Another decent ball in, header straight at Edwards. I think it was Okimo again forward. Parry. Hall Johnson, Beanie barges him away. Finds Green. Lovely idea with the pass. And here goes Sakaja running towards the Braintree area. Up against Manny Parry now. He's gone for goal, deflects into the arms of Besant. Deflection actually made it sit up nicely for the goalkeeper. I think it will be across from Carew. Carew's ready, so is the referee. And he has gone for goal, and that's saved by Besant. I thought it was out of his range, but has got a lot of power in those free kicks, Carew. Cargbo might be into trouble here. Here's Hall Johnson. It's just taking a little wide. That's a brilliant block. Lee charged down again by Ming. Twice he's done that, and Green pokes it away for a corner. Great defending, Sanchez Ming. Not once, but twice there. We've seen what they can do from these set pieces this evening. It comes towards near post. Flick goalwards. And somehow Lee Bernard has not applied the finishing touch. It just stabbed at it and it's rolled into the arms of Edwards. Flicked on the front post. Not sure if it was Carew or a Braintree man who got the touch. Bernard should have scored. Tomlin. Linking up with Ming. That's a lovely touch from Tomlin. Ming can try and pull this back perhaps. Drawn across goal. Touch from Besson. Green's out of the post and wide. What a chance that is. And Gavin Rose knows it on the bench as well. Deflected through to Green, not too far out, only hit the outside the post and wide. And how crucial might that be later on tonight? Into the 60th minute in this FA Trophy third round replay. Beanie has moved away from it now. for his last free kick was straight at the goalkeeper. A bit more central this time. Can they produce a moment of magic here? The Dulwich midfielder. Low, and that's comfortable for Beasant. Saw it all the way, the goalkeeper. Comfortable save, routine for him. Drage has that away. They're breaking forward though in numbers. Clohessy. Twardek was on the overlap. Goes inside to Lee. Chez Isaac. Step over to get away from the challenge. Deflects off Chambers. Corner kick. And a corner for Hall Johnson to send in. Drage and Weatherstone went for the same ball. One of them got the touch. Back here with Lee. Can find a pocket of space. Yes, he can. Gearing up the shot. Drage sticks out a foot and clears. Isaac. And he finds Carew. Tomlin wants it. And Tomlin's in. It's 2-on-2 here for Dulwich. Gavin Tomlin. Away from Isaac. Is he? Yes, he is. Bearing down on goal. Tomlin. 3-1. Oh, what a moment in this season it could be from Gavin Tomlin. Classic counter-attack by the host. And he jumps into the crowd. That's what it means to them. There's still a long way to go in this game, but they have breathing space. Held off Chez Isaac. Buries it in the far corner. Awareness, though, from Carew to pick out the pass initially. Played over the top for Tomlin. And despite the best efforts of Isaac, he bore down on goal. Fires it across Beasant. Dulwich a 3-1 up. Will Johnson delivers that. Flick goalwards, and Edwards pounced on the ball. Parry got the final touch, I think. Almost crept in that bottom corner. Not for a moment it had. Edwards pouncing on the ball, though. Green, Sakadja, Carew. Tomlin round the corner for Ming. Suddenly there's some swagger in their play. What can Ming do here? He's gone for goal. Flying over the crossbar from the right wing back. Clohessy takes it quickly. Only Midson in there. Edwards called it. Quick distribution again. We'll look for Tomlin. Renewing his tussle with Goodman. Tomlin holds him off. May go himself again. Does drill it goalwards, and Beasant holds on to the low drive from Gavin Tomlin. Will Johnson delivers over Drage. Chambers, I think, got the touch. That was vital, he did. Cargbrough sees it away. Sakadja looking to get on to the end of that. Clohessy taking a risk against Tomlin. And he's brought him down. And he's going to be in a lot of trouble here, Clohessy. Braintree's evening goes from bad to worse. Well, he had to bring him down and sacrifice his place on the field for his side. Because Tomlin was in one-on-one. It was his mistake which gifted Tomlin possession of the ball there. And Braintree's evening has got that much more difficult with the dismissal of Sean Clohessy. Expect this Dulwich defence to be tested over the last 13 minutes or so. Down the line it goes from Isaac, Hall Johnson. Trying to get away from Ming, can't do that, and Dulwich can swarm forward if they choose. Got Carew to his left, Tomlin and Sakadja ahead of him. They go back in with Ming, Tomlin trying to stay onside. Ming's gone for goal himself. Oh, that is sensational! What a way to book your place in the quarterfinals! Sanchez Ming, take a bow. Not many goalkeepers would have saved that. Dulwich Hamlet 4, Braintree Town 1. It's a famous night for this football club. He who won the ball in his own half came forward. Played it to Carew, laid it back off for Ming, struck it from distance, well beyond the reach of the goalkeeper, and Dulwich can look forward to that Macclesfield game now. Henschel with a free kick. It's 4-2. Manny Parry gets up. Maybe they're not done and dusted. A little over 10 minutes to play. It's another set piece which has been Dulwich's undoing. Almost stunned silence in the ground. Great ball in by Henschel. Their set pieces have been excellent tonight. Parry stole in, nodded it across Edwards. And maybe this game isn't done and dusted just yet. Forwards to get a touch. A lot of them as well. Alex Henshaw steps up, does go for goal, hits Cargbo. Into 6 minutes of added time. There is still enough time for Braintree to stage a comeback. Groans from the crowd where they hear the number. Henshaw goes for goal and that's off target. That eats up a few seconds. So anyway, they have done well in the FA Cup earlier in the season. Losing to Millwall at the Den. Second best tonight against Dulwich. Not too far from Millwall, of course. Ming. Sakadja. Ming continues his run. Gets there first. Oh, it's five. What a way to round it off. Jacob Erskine on his second Dulwich debut. What an absolutely wonderful night for Dulwich Hamlet. And they crown it off in injury time. Well played from Sanchez Ming. Played the 1-2. Determined to get there ahead of the goalkeeper, just chipped it over him. Erskine had a relatively simple header from close range. Dulwich at five. Not many people would have expected this scoreline tonight. Just going to hold on to the ball, Nathan Green now. Beats the challenge, sends in the cross. Erskine couldn't bring it down. Mohamed goes for goal. Well, that would have been sensational if he found the target there, but volley's over. Mohamed. 10 seconds to play. On the top by Midson. Drage back to Edwards. Referee blows for full time. You don't need me to tell you what a special night this is for Dulwich Hamlet. You can hear it around the ground. You'd see it around the ground. Dulwich Hamlet have scored five against a National League side to reach the quarterfinals of the FA Trophy for just the second time in their history. They took the lead after 28 minutes from the penalty spot. Gavin Tomlin was fouled. Ashley Carew stepped up and sent Sam Beasant the wrong way. Back came Braintree, it was level at the break. Jerome Okimo heading home a corner to make it 1-1, but Dulwich controlled the second half. They bossed the second half. Firstly, an own goal from Manny Parry gave them a bizarre 2-1 lead. Gavin Tomlin, just past the hour mark, made it 3 on a classic counter-attack. Sanchez Ming, with goal of the night, made it 4-1, a long-range effort. Smashed it from long range past the goalkeeper. Braintree had a tiny bit of hope, 10 minutes to play. Manny Parry rectified his earlier own goal by heading them a second. But deep in injury time, Jacob Erskine with a fifth. Dulwich will play Macclesfield Town here at the end of February for the quarterfinals. Final score then on a historic, famous evening at Champion Hill in this FA Trophy third round replay is Dulwich Hamlet 5, Braintree Town 2. How proud are you of the team performance again tonight?
Very proud. I think that would rank as our best performance of the season, considering who we've played against, a National League team, and our performance matched them. They have a lot of chances, but we had a lot of chances. We took ours today, but I'll take that all day long.
It's decent. The boys done well, to be fair. I mean, in the first half, you know, we was lucky to still be 1-0. It came back in half-time, you know, kind of changed things up a little bit, and the boys responded, and I thought that was magnificent.
I was going to say, first off, did you think that performance levels were slightly down from what it was first off on Saturday?
I just thought they pressed us really high. We just couldn't get out. Second half, I think they blew up a bit. They couldn't keep pressing us so high. So second half, we got out a little bit more and we got opportunities.
I think it was a great team performance. You know, just to overcome a team that is two leagues above us, it's a very important win for us.
And a special performance over two games. Well, not just tonight, it was carrying on from Saturday.
Exactly, you know, and we're getting to the back end of the season where our performances need to be consistent if we're looking to challenge for the title. So every game we want to go in and we want to win.
On Saturday you said we could beat them, but did you expect a scoreline like that, in all honesty?
No, not really. I suppose I think the mentality of them to try and win the game possibly helped us on the break. And we were clinical today. We took our chances on the break, which I feel sometimes we haven't, but I was delighted that we did tonight.
Hakan, firstly, just how disappointed are you with that second half tonight in particular?
Game of two halves, wasn't it? For an hour I thought we were excellent. You know, we gave away a sloppy goal from a penalty. And then, do you call it a fluke goal? A good play by Dulwich, hit him in the back of the head, it's gone in. Or the back, and it's gone in. And fair play to him. You know, he never gave up. He chased it down, and he got his rewards. Maybe my goalkeeper should have reacted a bit quicker. Maybe the back pass should have been better. But fair play to Dulwich. And let's not take nothing away from Dulwich. They were excellent again. good team. I've said this before and I'll say it again. Good outfit, but with the chances that we should have buried the game a long time ago.
Both games, we had our chance in the second half, counter-attack and try and really stretch their defence. Tonight, it just obviously took them, didn't we?
Yeah. I mean, to be fair, I thought Saturday we was excellent. We passed the ball really well. And credit to Braintree, to be fair, because they respected us and they showed that and they pressed the boys. Like Kenny said, we had no time in midfield, no time at the back. They really pressed us. As I said, the second half, the boys have come out, changed tactics a little bit, and you know, it's really worked.
Do you think actually first half you maybe weren't quite as good as Saturday? It seemed a bit sloppy in possession.
Yeah, we were sloppy in possession. They counteracted how we play. We took a little bit of time to get used to that, I thought. But once we had a chance to get in at half time, because we were quite lucky to get in at 1-1, we reorganised ourselves and we had a little bit more confidence as well in ourselves, and I felt that we looked probably the stronger team.
They was definitely on top of the game, I would say. I didn't think they created any clear-cut chances. I think defended pretty well. We always knew that there was dangerous from set plays, and we tried to limit them in the first half, but then second half, Ashley Carew gave away about 23 kicks to compound, you know, them scoring from set plays. So something I'll have a word with him about.
First half, you pressed them a lot higher and tried to get onto them a lot quicker than you did on Saturday.
Yeah. Well, I thought it worked. And you know how many chances we're going to have, especially second half as well. Game should have been done. Game should have been done, but it wasn't. And you got some good players here, and they punished us, especially going down at 10 minutes. It was difficult. But that's football. You got to dust yourselves, pick yourselves up, and go again.
After Whitehawk asked you where that ranked in terms of your performances, your matches since you've been in charge, is this one right towards the top, do you think?
I suppose, yeah. I suppose at the end of the day, we've got the club into a quarter final of the trophy, which we haven't been in. So, like I say, if we keep doing that, then it's always going to get better. It's always going to get one better, no matter who we play against. But the atmosphere was fantastic today on a Tuesday night. They contributed. They contributed to a great night as well. I thought they played really well. Caused us loads of problems. I think some of our players I've always thought can play a higher level. Showed again that, you know, why I believe they can play a higher level. They rose to the occasion. And the challenge for me, my staff and the players is now to get that sort of tune out of us for the rest of the season.
It's a special night tonight, you know, but as I said, to be fair, the boys can enjoy it tonight. They've done really well. They've earned that. Not just today, Saturday, they've done really well. You know, it's a National League side, two leagues above us. And you could see that in the first half. You could see that. For us now, we just need to get to the training ground on Thursday, get our focus back. We've got a massive game at Bognor, which we need to grab something from.
I see the goal shared around today as well.
Yeah, definitely. Good share of the goals. Good to see Jacob, who's really helping us out because we've got so many injuries, come back in and show everyone how much quality he's got, you know. We can't forget the boys had a bad injury. Been out all season, no pre-season. It's great for him to play in front of that crowd because that's what he's used to. He's played a good level of football and he's shown his class, so happy for him.
When you play a side against Braintree and it's a big cup tie, you need all 11 men to stand up and be counted. Over two games they did that. How pleasing was it from you as an experienced player seeing everyone else in the team contribute?
Yeah, definitely. And a positive thing for me is that we still can improve. You know, and we beat a team 5-2 today. So that shows how much belief we have in the team and the players that we have here.
And how special was it to see Sanchez's goal? I mean, he's not renowned for his goal scoring, but it was a pretty good strike from where you were standing.
I couldn't believe it, to be honest. Everyone is telling him not to shoot, to pass it to me, but you know, it's a fantastic strike and I'm happy for him.
Just finally, I know it's still a couple of weeks away, but Macclesfield coming down there, 15 years in the Football League, how great a test is that going to be?
Massive. It's a big club, massive club. But for us, it's an adventure now. We've got nothing to lose but other than going out there and representing ourselves well, representing the team well and the club well. So we've got nothing to lose, we'll give it our best shot.
So is your playing career, how does this rank as an overall night?
Well, I've never got to the quarterfinals of the FA Trophy, so no, you've won it, haven't you, Kez? Yeah, so it's quite high up there, yeah.
So obviously, as Kenny's alluded, you have won it. You said you're only getting a bit worried once the side reached the last date. Are you feeling a bit nervous now?
No, we've got a big game on Saturday against Bognor.
Good answer.